Paramahamsa Nityananda, a rare living incarnation, is named among the world's 100 most spiritually influential personalities today. Paramahamsa Nityananda has been placed alongside Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind Body Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages, in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian, and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapitam, a spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters, India's most watched spiritual guru online, a beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
वंदे पाप विनाशकम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् नित्यमुक्तम् निर्विकल्पम् ध्यानलोक प्रदीपकम् वंदे शांतमयम् बंधम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् आनंद गंध संचारम् सर्वोपाधि विनिर्मुक्तम् वंदे ज्ञानालयम् नाथम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम्।
The first question is from Suman from Kolkata, India. She writes, "My dear Swamiji, the other day in satsang, you advised a mother not to pass on her negative patterns to her child. This got me really scared because I feel that I'm doing exactly that with my four-year-old daughter. After all, I am nothing but a bundle of habits and patterns. What else will I pass on to her? Swamiji, can you give me some tips on how unenlightened parents can bring up their child to live an enlightened life?" Suman, Kolkata, India.
Suman, there is no way an unenlightened parent can bring up a child in an enlightened way. But I can give you one thing. You also start practicing the enlightened cognizance. What is enlightened cognizance? It is not something unachievable, impossible. Come on. See, when I say enlightened cognizance, I just say few concepts. Whenever you are responding, look at it. Is it bringing happiness to you? Is it bringing happiness to other person? Is it large good? Just simple. Whatever you learned in the class 1, class 2, those basic simple truths. But only thing, it has to be drilled to the deeper levels of you. See, every man at one level stops the spiritual depth and says, no, for practical reasons I have to behave like this. The level which you stop responding spiritually and start saying practicality, that has to go down. That's all. Nothing else. Some people, the moment they need to spend 5 rupees, they say, no, 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 I have to be very practical. Some people, when they need to spend 5 lakh, they say, no, 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 I have to be very practical. Some people, when they need to lose 5 crore, then they say, no, I have to be very practical. It just depends on the depth, on your depth, nothing else. Suman, you may be unenlightened. That is forgivable. But if you are not living enlightenment, that is not forgivable. Being unenlightened is forgivable, tolerable. But if you are not living enlightenment, that is not forgivable. That's your freedom. Come on. It's under your will. It's in your choice. If you are saying, I am unenlightened, I have all my sympathy for you. But if you say, you are not living enlightenment, I have no sympathy for you. You need to be taught a lesson. You need to learn. It is time you start living enlightenment. It is not something impossible. Just the basic truths. Understanding much of your responses are chemical imbalances. Understanding your anger, your greed, your lust, your fear. All of them have no base. Just understanding. I saw in my life, you see, handling so many millions of bodies and minds, doing millions of psychological surgeries. See, every time when I attend a problem of somebody, it is equivalent to psychological surgery. First, I have to make that person trust I can solve the problem. That is the psychological anesthesia. Only then he will open up. Then I have to use a subtle energy which gives him deep confidence and courage on me and start listening to his problems. That is what is opening the wound. Then giving the solution means removing the tumor. Finally, I have to give post-surgery care, means meditation technique. After performing thousands of psychological surgeries, I really tell you, the moment human beings feel they are unenlightened, they close the whole possibility. Being unenlightened is not crime, but not living enlightenment is crime. Suman, you being unenlightened is not just your responsibility. God is also responsible. So I don't want to blame you for that. But you not living enlightenment, you are only responsible. So when you say, I am just bundle of patterns and habits, don't think you are great and you are honest. Suman, I don't want you to be honest. I want you to be authentic. I am not expecting you to have that pseudo honesty. Blah, blah, blah. I am not a Gandhi. You are not a Gandhian. Understand? I want you to be authentic. I am not just interested in your honesty. There are so many fellows come and tell me, oh, I am done this, I have done this, I have done this, I have done this, I am honest to you. What is the use for me? I don't want to see the pornography of listening to whatever you have done. No. Many of these pornographic autobiographies became very popular. Because, not because of your honesty, because of the pornographic effect. Many people come out and say, oh, I have done this, I have done this, I have done this, I have done all this in my life. They write in their biography. It sells like anything. Why? Not because the person is honest, but because the pornographic effect of it. When people read that, they go through that experience psychologically. So I am not interested in your honesty. I am interested in your authenticity. Authenticity means living the solution. Honesty means talking about the problem again and again and again and again and again. I am not interested in honesty. I am interested in authenticity. Live the life. Live. Authenticity is what? All you need. Just do one thing. Get a two-way connection. And whenever you sit and watch the satsang, see that your child is also around. That's all, nothing else. You don't know how they will grow. Don't think they will not hear, they will not understand and all that. They understand much more than you. You don't know the power of kids. In their memory, whole thing gets recorded. I tell you, this is a very powerful way. If you want to bring up your kids, first option, bring them to our Gurukul. If that is not possible, at least get to a connection and make Gurukul in your house. That's all. If mountain is not able to come to Muhammad, Muhammad will go to mountain. That's all. If you are not able to come to me, I am coming to you. Have two-way connection. Let them just sit and listen, listen, listen. That's enough. Suman, but don't take the risk of continue to have these patterns and pass on these patterns to next generation.
Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experiences.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapitam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.
Mark Williams is asking, my dear Swamiji, I was just blown away by what you said in Dialed Avatar the other day about the guru-disciple relationship being like a black hole and Big Bang. You were answering a small kid on the Dialed Avatar and you said, when you enter into me, it's a black hole. When I enter into you, it's a Big Bang. Can you please speak more on this? Williams, when you enter into me, you disappear into something beyond you. That's what we call black hole. Black hole means all these planets, everything disappearing into something which is beyond your comprehension, beyond your understanding. So when you disappear into something which is beyond your comprehension, that is black hole. I made another one said to me, when I enter into you, it is Big Bang. Means, what is Big Bang? Whatever you see appearing from something which you can't understand is Big Bang. Understand, when I enter into you, it is Jivan Mukti, living enlightenment. When you enter into me, it is Videha Mukti, enlightenment beyond body. So Big Bang means what? Initiation. I'm me entering into you, you experiencing new you. At some day, suddenly you will feel even the trace of your old identity is not there in you. I felt this when I left the house and went to Ramakrishna Mission. Just within few days, I can say in a week, I felt like as if I have been washed. Wow. I forgot many of the dear things to my life. You know, I forgot Arunachala Temple. That was the most dearest place to me, place for me on the earth. I forgot the structure and map of Arunachala Temple. After a month, for some other reason, somebody asked me a question about Arunachala Temple. Suddenly I remembered, oh God, I forgot Arunachala Temple, which is my very life. I used to breathe only in the temple. Early morning when I wake up, before even I start breathing, I will be there already in the temple. In the night, practically from temple, I will directly jump to the house bed and fall asleep. I lived practically in temple, but I forgot. Because suddenly, when your identity moves away from you, something completely new happens in you, takes over you. I tell you, that new taking over you is Big Bang. Buddha's enlightenment is black hole. Shankara's enlightenment is Big Bang. Shankara constantly talks about Puranatva. Buddha constantly talks about Sunyatva. But both ultimately is one and the same. Whether it is Big Bang or black hole, you won't understand both. So I'll go on be speaking. Mark, you will never be able to hear. I tell you, that is Upanishad. Upanishad means, I am constantly speaking. You will never be able to hear anything, but your heart will be listening. Me speaking, you will not be hearing. But whatever you are hearing, you will not be understanding. But your heart will be listening. That is what is Upanishad. I tell you, working with the master, directly doing work as per his guidance and instructions and working around him is the extension, continuous learning process. Because that clarifies many of the spiritual truths to you. Makes you understand about living enlightenment, makes living enlightenment possible. Living. So even though you don't understand, I'll make one more statement. Black hole is making you whole. Big bang is bang to wake you up. Black hole is making you as whole. Big bang is inner awakening. Understand? Biggest bang on your consciousness is inner awakening. Receive that biggest bang. You will become whole.
क्या आप स्वयं एक अवतार पुरुष से अपने जीवन में दिव्य मार्गदर्शन चाहते हैं? प्रस्तुत करते हैं अवतार पुरुष से वार्ता।
नित्यानंदम, नित्यानंदा हियर।
परमहंस नित्यानंदा संसार को एक और अतुल्य और अनोखी भेंट दे रहे हैं।
Got practically everything and too much for a phone call.
अब वो लाइव किसी के भी प्रश्नों का उत्तर स्वयं देंगे।
That's great. No, you ask anything you want in your life. Ask me any boon you want.
आठ से प्रारंभ। कुछ सौभाग्यशाली लोग जो 0800-27-27-99-99 पर फोन करेंगे, वो स्वयं स्वामी जी से बात कर सकते हैं। लाइव देखें एनटीवी पर ntv.nityananda.org।
The Ingenious Program, a field of all possibilities. The children in the Ingenious Program are directly under the guidance of enlightened master Paramahamsa Nityananda. Nityananda is an incarnation and exudes the knowledge of conflict-free living. He states that enlightenment is our birthright. What an incredible gift for your child, a once-in-a-lifetime privilege to live and thrive in the energy field of all possibilities and give enlightenment to your child. Where every child can become a genius. Learning can unveil the genius in every child, provided it stimulates higher-order thinking skills, positive self-esteem, teamwork, and an internal locus of control. Research has proven that holistic teaching methodologies paired with meditation stimulate whole brain functioning and result in self-directed, spontaneous, and creative lifelong learners. An enriched environment. When young children have an enriched environment conducive to early learning in life, they have higher IQ, cognitive intelligence, EQ, social emotional intelligence, and SQ, spiritual intelligence. These early experiences are critical for the development of the child. Peer pressure and destructive social conditioning can take its toll on the child. It can create negative thought patterns and destructive behaviors unless these enriching experiences are provided. An enriched environment includes whole brain activities which stimulate the utilization of both sides of the brain. The right brain is responsible for creativity, intuition, spontaneity, quantum memory, learning in a flash, and computer-like calculations. The left side of the brain is responsible for inner linear thinking and analysis. When both sides of the brain are integrated, performance is optimal. Brain yoga. Brain yoga activates the ability to balance the right and the left brain. This helps open the sixth sense. Children are given activities to balance both sides of the body simultaneously using distinctive postures that stimulate both sides. The neurological brain patterns move from beta to alpha, increasing alertness and attention. Quantum memory. Quantum memory is a constant downloading of information without interference of the mind. Observation skills are directly related to memory skills. Reading without interference of the mind, reading at quantum speed, will lead to quantum memory without the mind getting in the way. Creative and performing arts. Dance, drama, music, sculpting and design offered in the Ingenious program provide kinesthetic motor stimulation to engage the brainwave patterns, resulting in expanded creativity and resourcefulness. Sattvic food. Children are given the benefit of fresh sattvic food prepared to the standards according to the ancient Vedic lifestyle. The food is fresh, with fruits and vegetables. Vegetarian food creates radiant health in the body. Vedic cultural arts. Sanskrit chanting stimulates the brain to produce full brain coherence, developing clearer perception and integrated thinking. Chanting also promotes inner silence and improves the attention span. Meditation and expanded awareness. Meditation instills a deep silence in the child, resulting in deeper, richer perception and clarity in thinking. Ingenious produces the next step in evolution, a mature human being who functions at a higher state of consciousness. Expanded awareness provides the platform for a vision of abilities of life, perfect health, prosperity, and life without conflict. What more could you ask for your child?
If I can just teach this one science to the kids, I will have millions of enlightened beings.
The next question is from Eva Whiteley, London, UK. She asks, Dear Swamiji, after attending Inner Awakening, I find that I am just not able to relate to my old job and life in the same way. I want to be more tolerant, but sometimes I feel like I am just bursting out and not fitting into my earlier identity. I think my husband especially is concerned and scared. How to handle this new life, Swamiji? Eva Whiteley from London, UK.
Eva Whiteley, I want you to see the Matrix movie. It is exactly the people who have woken up, their situation. I tell you, it is beautiful problem to have. It is 1,000 times greater than the problem sleeping people are facing. I tell you, I'll have to put it in this way. The ultimate comfort sleeping people are having is worse than greatest problem a woken up man is living. Understand, woken up man having problem is much better than sleeping man only having comforts. People always tend, no, even if I am sleeping, it's okay. If it is comfortable, that's enough. Then why don't you bury yourself? You will never have any problem. You are there all the time, just sitting like almost Buddha. That's not life. Don't you see? That is not life. So, Eva Whiteley, as on now, you need little patience, tolerance, but you should not compromise. Having tolerance and patience is different. Compromising is different. Compromising means you should not come down from your spiritual cognizance. The way you make decisions, the way you think, the spiritual cognitive shift you experienced, that should not be compromised. Don't come down from that. Add little more tolerance. Try to turn blind eye for some problems. That is allowed. Out of compassion, you can just turn your eyes the other side. But you yourself should not bend, should not come down from the way you take decisions. The spiritual cognitive shift should not be reduced. And show little tolerance. Don't worry. Your husband will not be scared. He will only be happy. Just do not allow your ego to fight with people live with confidence. Confidence will always bring tolerance. When I can tolerate with you, you can tolerate with anybody. Understand, Eva? When I can tolerate you, you can tolerate anybody. Just remember this one statement. When Swamiji can tolerate me, I should be able to tolerate anybody on the world. That's it.
Just an hour's drive from Bangalore, Asia's fastest growing city, is a unique space of healing, meditation, and rejuvenation. Welcome to Nityananda Dhyanapeetam. Experience soothing, healing energies under the ancient wish-fulfilling banyan tree in the presence of divinity. Enjoy the unique anti-aging formula of the original Siddha Healing Spa with the 21-foot energized healing lingam and healing pool, the Vaidya Sarovar. Connect directly to God in the vibrant silence of Nityanandeshwara Temple. Savor the delicious sattvic food served free at all times. Best of all, get a glimpse of authentic spiritual life at the daily morning satsang, worship, yoga and meditation sessions with Paramahamsa Nityananda. Rediscover yourself at Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, the ultimate spiritual lifestyle destination. Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, Biridi, Bengaluru, 97422-03311.
सहस्रशो वै शागुं हेडयीमहे असव्यो वसत्पति नीलग्रीवो विलोहितः उदयनं गोपा
asking, respected Swamiji, During the daily kriya, whenever we are asked to hold our breath for a long time, lot of fear comes up and I start gasping for breath. I never managed to do the kumbhaka properly. Why do I have this fear? How to get over it? Silesh, one of the worst thing happened to you Indians is you guys have lost the truth. You can be without thoughts. See, fear of kumbhaka, holding the breath, is nothing but fear of being without thoughts. You are afraid of being without thoughts. Even few moments you are without thoughts, the consciousness will grip you. Consciousness will conquer you. Consciousness will capture you. Your mind will be replaced by consciousness. You will wake up, which is too much. You Indians had only one thing, the wealth of consciousness. You lost it after the independence. Because the only wealth you had is the power of consciousness. You lost it and you are not even aware of it. Wake up, India. It's with tremendous pain I am telling you. Any poverty is okay for India, but not spiritual poverty. Because we never built our identity on wealth, but we've built our identity on spiritual richness. We never built our identity on wealth, but we always built our identity on spiritual richness. Aray, when Europe was going through a dark age, when there was no civilization, when there was only tribals, we had buildings reaching the sky, built in granite for our ideology, for our spiritual richness. In the corner of Tanjore, understand, identity of India is spiritual richness. When you lose that, you lost everything. The moment you say you are not able to hold the breath for a long time, lot of fear comes up. Silesh, you are the new gen of India. There was no Indian gene. I feel sad for you. And the new generation of India, it is nothing but simply trusting you can live without thoughts and it is good for you. Just remember this one idea. When you are gasping for breath, suddenly you will be able to do kumbhaka for a longer period. Understand, I am giving you the solution. If you are having difficulty in kumbhaka, gasping for breath, just remember one thing. Hey, it is nothing but my fear to be in thoughtless space. I can be thoughtless. Nothing wrong. Relax from the fear of being thoughtless. You will be able to hold your breath for a long time. You will be able to do kumbhaka for a long time. Simply, the kumbhaka will happen. Fear of kumbhaka is nothing but fear of thoughtlessness. Fear of thoughtless space. Fear of holding breath is nothing but fear of thoughtless space. I tell you, when the fear of thoughtless space disappears, even little bit of yoga will make you have a long breath. Long breath creates a new energy in you, life in you. It creates samana in you. Actually, all yoga, kumbhaka, meditation, pranayama, technique, everything is just to create long breaths in you. Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bangalore, 562-109. Contact 0974220331. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.